It's important to have mad friends in your life, isn't it? People who just kind of stretch your head a little bit. I have one friend left from my early 20s who's like that. He hasn't been neutered by a long-term relationship. He's full of this wild, ferocious sexual energy, but it's not wrapped up in any charm. He has no idea of his own physical limitations. Decided recently he was going to run a marathon. Trained for about a week beforehand. So I often ran 26 miles when I was drunk. Looking for a party. I'd probably win the thing. He would take no dissuading whatsoever. The start of the race. Where does the bold Brendan go? Not at the back, with all the humble amateur athletes dressed up as restaurants and werewolves. Oh no! He has a chance of winning the thing. So he elbows his way down to the front of this international marathon. And he's standing there, stomach against the ticker tape, shoulder to shoulder with all the men from Somalia and Ethiopia. They're all there in their sleek Adidas outfits, singlets and expensive shorts. Brendan is in an AC/DC t-shirt. With the sleeves torn off for aerodynamic purposes. The race began, and he said he was able to keep up with them for the first 4 miles. Now that's an achievement, because they don't hang around, they're just gone. They're like gazelle men, just, and Brendan there. He said after 4 miles he got so tired that he wasn't able to slow down. He said that if he didn't come to an abrupt stop, he was going to die. So rather than stand to one side and to be seen to be a bit of a fool, what he did was he very suddenly and dramatically just veered off course. As if this is what he had planned all along. He veered off course, jumped over a hedge and lay in a garden. Without a word of explanation to his fellow athletes. What has happened to Brendan? I don't know. He was scaring me. Metal. Was he the devil? I don't know. Montreal, it's been a pleasure talking to you.